Tibet, the land of the free, the land of the monks, the land where human experience is taken to another dimension. Tibet, the land which has been subjugated, the land which has been occupied, whose people are being mercilessly hounded by communist China. That Tibet today seeks freedom. The people of Tibet have sent the CCP a clear message. But more than the CCP, the message for the world is even more resounding. Come to Tibet's rescue and you will not fail. Will the free world order stand up to China as they have on issues like Hong Kong, Taiwan and Xinjiang? Will Tibet get the recognition it deserves? The democratic world is faced with a test. Tibet needs to be freed from China and it needs to be freed now. Hi and welcome. This is TFI Global, the foreign affairs and geopolitical analysis arm of the TFI Media Group. I am your host, Sanbir Ranhotra, and in this video, I will tell you how Tibetans have snubbed the CCP and sent a message to the world community. Let's begin. China is embroiled in a tense military standoff with India for the past 18 months now, and during this time, the CCP has been humiliated time and again. The PLA, on its part, has had the necks of its soldiers mercilessly snapped by Indian bravehearts who are continuously giving hell to the communist nation in eastern Ladakh, in a bid to perhaps save face in the Himalayas, where it has gotten embroiled with the battle-hardened Indian forces. The PLA had earlier this year ensued a desperate lookout for Tibetans to serve China as soldiers. Essentially, the CCP was working out a mechanism where Tibetans help the Chinese state in colonizing Tibet, which is already a victim of illegal Chinese occupation. However, this effort has proven to be a disaster like no other. According to a report by Times Now, despite China's all-out efforts to recruit Tibetans in the People's Liberation Army and paramilitary outfits, the response from Tibetans has been tepid. This, despite the strong-arm tactics and efforts by the CCP to force monks to bless the new recruits. The Times Now report said, in the Nari Prefecture, the westernmost part of Tibet, adjoining Ladakh, the PLA had laid down the law, one young man from every household, and despite all that and a handsome stipend, only 63 have joined. They are being trained for 3 months at Shikan. The other area where there has been forced recruitment is the Chumbi Valley, adjoining Sikkim. Recruitment began on August 2nd and the cadets are being trained at Nakchu in Tibet from September 16th. The curriculum includes physical training, drill and maintenance of accommodation. The recruits have had to hand over their mobile phones to the authorities. They are allowed only one phone call home. Essentially, China had thought it could conduct a mass enrollment of Tibetan conscripts to fight for it against India. However, those plans have now proven to be a dud. China also planned at driving a wedge within the Tibetan community with its enrollment exercise. However, Tibetans have resoundingly slapped the CCP and its private militia force, the PLA, in the face. Tibetans, who share a culture with India, have made it clear that they have no interest in fighting on behalf of the PLA or for it. The PLA is known to commit the most horrifying of atrocities and human rights violations on Tibetans. As such, Tibetans do not want to be a part of the PLA's sins and are instead choosing to reject the CCP's moves in their land. It was in 1950 that the newly established People's Republic of China had launched an invasion in Tibet, which until then was a free and sovereign region with a unique culture that bears little to no resemblance to that of China. The Chinese armed forces marched across Tibet until early 1951 and established Chinese control over the region subsequently. Back then, scores of Tibetans, including the topmost leader of the Tibetan Buddhist order, the Dalai Lama, had fled to India seeking refuge. India provided a safe shelter to Tibetan refugees, and today the community is thriving in the country and has even set up a Tibetan government in exile at Dharamshala. For several centuries now, India and Tibet have inextricably been tied to each other, and China has always envied the bond which these two great civilizations share. Buddhism, which originated out of India, was quick to sweep all across Tibet. Tibetans have a sense of respect for Indian culture, which is from where their own faith originated. So, when the PLA asked ordinary Tibetans to join its ranks, they all knew what the task would entail. Not only would it include betraying their own people, but it would also mean that the CCP would make them fight India. Now, Tibetans are in no mood to fight either their own people or India. So, most of them have decided to give a pass to the PLA's recruitment drive. Furthermore, Tibetans know that India, under Prime Minister Narendra Modi, is gradually stepping up the rhetoric for their land to be freed from the clutches of communist China. As such, they are simply not motivated enough to pick up arms against India. Chinese soldiers cannot stand the unforgiving climate of the Himalayas, especially in eastern Ladakh, where the PLA and Indian Army are engaged in a standoff. The Han Chinese, which make the bulk of the PLA's fighting force, are simply too unmanly to fight in harsh conditions. During the last winters, these snowflake-like soldiers collapsed in eastern Ladakh like paper cards. It is the incapacity of Han soldiers to survive the Himalayan winters which forced the PLA to recruit Tibetans in the first place. However, Tibetans hate the Chinese. Tibetans would rather see PLA soldiers die fighting India than act as their substitutes by being recruited in the PLA. The people of Tibet want independence from India. That automatically means that the war for Tibet's freedom is half won. If the people of Tibet do not want to live under Chinese subjugation, it goes without saying that the CCP will not be able to hold its fort for long. As a matter of fact, Xi Jinping is being forced to resort to optics now. Recently, for the first time after resuming the role of the Chinese president, Xi Jinping visited Tibet and orchestrated what was a grand welcome for himself, in which CCP stooges pretended to be Tibetan citizens who were overwhelmed to see their supreme leader among them. So, the CCP is really clutching on to the last straws now. It is now time for the free world to step up efforts to free Tibet from China. The people of Tibet want freedom, and the least that democracies around the world can do is deliver the same to them.